Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I welcome you all once again to our grammar lessons. Inshallah, we are taking the next topic today, which is Anwa'ul Bina. We've explained to ourselves, and I'm hopeful and I'm sure we've all understood very well the concept of Al-Bina and Al-I'rab. When we say Al-Bina, we mean words that are indeclinable. Al-Bina, the case of a word when it cannot change, its ending sticks to one vowel. It has just one case ending wherever it finds itself in a sentence. And when we say Al-I'rab or Al-Mu'rab, the case where the endings of the word keeps changing. Okay, so that said, if that is not clear, I think you can just refer to the previous lesson and get yourself abreast with that info. Okay, so Anwa ul Bina. First of all, let me explain Anwa here. Anwa is the plural of noun. When we say noun, we mean type. Anwa, types. Al Bina, indeclension, types of indeclension. Now, when we say types here, what we mean is the vowels, the various vowels that a word takes and it does not change at all forever. Do not take it woke up. It is just our four vowels. Dhamma, Fatha, Kesra, Sukun. Nothing special. Some words stick to Fatha all throughout, always. Some words stick to Dhamma, always. Some stick to Kesra and some to Sukun, always. That is what we call Anwa'ul Bina. So you know the word and you know that, oh, this word is Bina, is Mabni. Is Mabni, and the vowel it takes is Sukun. So we say Mabni ala Sukun. Mabni ala Sukun. If it takes Fatha always, you say Mabni ala al-Fathi. If it takes Kasra, Mabni ala al-Kasri. If it takes Dhamma, Mabni ala al-Dhammi. That is how it goes. Okay, so let's just go through quickly. It says Anwa'ul Bina, types of Bina, al-Amthila, examples. He says Kam Jawadan. Indaka. Jawad is horse, like his son. Kam Jawadan fil Maidan. And when you see the word coming after Kem takes Fathatain like this, it means the Kem here is istifhamiya, is for question. Even if they don't bring the question mark, you see Kem and the word that comes after it, like I say, Kem Qalaman Indak. I'm asking you, how many pens do you have? So if it says Kem Jawadan fil Maidan, Maidan, we've already said, is field or square. So how many horses are in the field? Number two, Bikem Ishtarayta Sa'ataka. How much did you buy your watch? Sa'a is watch. The word Sa'a is one of those words that have various meanings. When we say Sa'a, we mean watch, clock. It means an hour. It means time. Sa'a also means moment. We've explained it very well in our Al-Qira'at Rashida lessons, but these are the meanings. Sa'a can mean time, can mean the moment, can mean clock, can mean watch, an hour. Sometimes even used to mean a minute or something. It goes to that extent. Okay, so we have, so how much did you buy your watch? And then we have Kem Ta'idu Wala Tafi. Here is not questioning. He's saying Ta'idu is from Wa'ada, to promise. And Tafi is from Wafa. When we say somebody is Wafiyun, the person is honest, fulfills his promises. And he says, how many times you promise Wala Tafi and you do not fulfill? How many times? He's even amazed. How many times you promise and you do not fulfill it? Tadala al-jawu, tadala to become normal. The weather or the atmosphere has become normal. Number five, he says, hal tadala al-jawu, has the weather become normal? It's not sunny, it's not rainy like that. Al-jawu qad tadala. The weather has become normal. Now, qad here shows emphasis. I've said that cod and past tense, when they come, mostly they show emphasis. I've explained this several. Okay. Kif haythu anta. Kif stay or stand haythu anta, where you are. Stay where you are. Sir ila haythu shi'ta. Move towards where you want. Move to where you want to. Ila haythu shi'ta. To wherever you want to. Tuqimu haythu yatibul hawa. You stay where yatibul hawa. The air is good. Kana ams shadid al har. Yesterday was severely hot. Zurutul ahram ams. Al ahram is the pyramids. I visited the pyramids yesterday. Dhahabtu ams ila al qal'ati. I went yesterday to the qal'a. And since we've seen pyramid, then this qal'a here, they are referring to qal'at Salahuddin Ayyubi. Saladin's, that's Saladin's compound on the mountain. Is that even in Cairo? It's somewhere in those areas, not so far from Cairo, if it's not in Cairo. I'm sure it's in Cairo. Is that on that mountainous region like that? It's called Atu Salahuddin Ayyubi. Okay, so he said he went yesterday, Zahabtu, I went yesterday to the Qala'a, to the hall. When we say Qala'a, basically we mean a hall. Hall, whether it's for conference, whether it's for whatever. Okay, so we go to our explanation. He says, Allamana mimma taqaddama. We've been taught by what has preceded, anna al-mabni, that the construct, those that are indeclinable, huwa ma yulazim akhiruhu halatan wahidatan. We've already said that the word that is mabni is the one that yulazimu akhiruhu halatan wahidatan fi jami'i tarakib. This is the definition of mabni. Its ending is always constant with one vowel. Hala here means haraka, vowel. It's constant with one vowel in every sentence you find it. Its ending vowel does not change. Okay. Wa nuridu huna an na'rifa, and we want to know here al ahwal. This word al ahwal, if you find this ha here being a big ha, if it's not ha and it's ha, al ahwal, then we mean calamities, terror, that which gives fear. But when it's ahwal, so in Arabic we deal with sounds a lot. The meanings are taken from the sounds. Al ahwal. The people who master tajweed are very good in this aspect. So these are cases, plural of hawl. And al ahwal, terror, is the plural of hawl, the big ha. Okay, wa nuridu huna an na'rif al ahwal. An ahwal is also the vowels. We want here to know the cases of vowels. Allati tulazimu awakhir al mabniyat. Mabniyat is the plural of mabni. We want to know the vowels that the words that are mabni are always with. Okay, so you see a word is mabni, what vowel does it take? We gather all the mabni and we look at the vowels at their endings. As I've already said, nothing special, just the four vowels. Al-kalimat, the words kem, tadala, haythu, and ams. Fil amsilati sabiqati kulluha mabniya. In the previous examples, all of these are mabni, indeclinable nouns. Li'anna awakhiraha tulazimu ahwalan la tataghayyar mahma taghayyarat al-taraqib. Mahma, however. It is mabni because their endings never change. Their case endings, the vowels at the ends, the skun, the fatha, and after i'tadala, the haythu, the dhamma, the ams with kasra, they never change. Wherever mahma tagayyarat taraqib, however, the sentence structure changes. Okay, so it says for akhiru kem, the ending of kem, yulazimu sukun. You can see there it takes sukun always. وَمِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ يُقَالُ إِنَّهَا مَبْنِيَّةٌ عَلَى السُّكُونَ. And so due to this, we say that it is مَبْنِيَّةٌ عَلَى السُّكُونَ. it doesn't decline and its vowel is sukun. And وآخر اعتدل, the ending of اعتدل يلازم الفتح, is always with فتح. You can see it there, اعتدل. ومن أجل ذلك يقال, and due to that we say إنها مبنية على الفتح. Words like اعتدل, we say that it is مبني على الفتح. وآخر حيث, and the ending of حيث, can see it there, يلازم الضم, is constant with dom, never changes, domma. ومن أجل ذلك, and due to that, يقال, it is said, إنها, it is مبنية على الضم, it is constant with domma. وآخر أمس, and the ending of أمس, you can see here كسرة, أمس is always with كسرة, يلازم الكسر. ومن أجل ذلك, ومن أجل ذلك يقال إنها, and due to that it is said that it is مبني على الكسر, مبنية على الكسر, it is always constant with كسر. وإذا بحثنا في أواخر الكلمات المبنية, and if you look at the endings of the words that are مبني, لم نجد حالا أخرى غير هذه الحالات الأربع. If you look at the endings of words that are مبني, we do not find any other case ending غير هذه الحالات الأربعة, غير هذه الحالات الأربعة, except these four, فتحة, كسرة, ضمة, سكون, as I've already told you. وليست هناك قواعد خاصة, and there are no special rulings, تعرف بها, that is used to know أحوال أواخر الكلمات المبنية, to know the endings, case endings of words that are مبني. So there is no special ruling to know that words like min is always with skun. There is no special ruling for you to know that kem always ends with skun. You don't need any special rulings. وإنما المدار في ذلك على النقل من كتب اللغة الموثوق بها. What is considered here, what is done here in this field, وإنما المدار في ذلك, what is done here, the concept here is that في ذلك على النقل من كتب اللغة الموثوق بها, is how we pick them from Arabic books that are trusted, like Kitab Sibawi, and those books that they've, the scholars have written, the Khasais, Dems, and the books. The way we saw it from the Arabs, we use it like that. And then we say that, oh, since it always comes with sukun, it's mabniya ala sukun. We don't bother too much. Okay, that is all that about al-ahwal or anwa'ul bina. Okay, al-qawa'id, the ruling. Al-ahwal allati tulazimu awakhir al-kalimat. Al-ahwal here again, as I said, is harakat. So the vowels that the endings of words that are mabni indeclinable take are four. Arba'un, they are four. Wahia, and they are as-sukun, al-fath, al-dam, al-kasr. There is something I want you to note here. Al-fath, not al-fathatu. Al-fathatu, you realize that it is a sign for i'rab. When something is mabni and it takes fatha, we say the sign there is fath, not fathatu. So we say mabni al-fath, mabni al-dam, مبني على الكسر. You can just go back a bit and look at what they've written. That's why I highlighted it. You can see that it is not كسرتو, the skun, the term marbut is not there. You realize it's not ضمتو, ضم, كسر, فتح. So that is how they come. They don't come with a term marbut when we are talking about مبني and بنا and all that. Drop the term marbut. وتسمى أنواع البنا. So the أنواع البنا, what are they? السكون, الفتح, الضم, الكسر. You will understand the concept when we do أنواع الإعراب, inshallah. الكلمات التي يلازم أواخرها السكون أو الفتح أو الضم أو الكسر. Words that whose ending, words whose endings are constant with these vowels. Some words are just always with سكون, some are always with فتح, some are always with ضم, some are always with كسر. yukalu innaha, it is said that it is mabniyatun ala sukun awil fathi, look at it, awil dhammi awil kasri. So you either say a word like kam is mabni ala sukun, a word like tadala mabni ala fathi, and like that. Okay, I hope this is a very simple topic. That is why it is an-nahwul wadih, clear grammar, very easy grammar. It takes us through it step by step, little by little, so that we are able to build comfortably. It is said in one of these wise sayings in a book called Qatarat min yara, drops of fireflies. It says as-sur'atu sawtun yatrudu biha al-ijada. Hastening is a kind of cane that is used to chase away perfection. You shouldn't hasten. Gradually, we will come to understand the whole concept as we move slowly like this. May Allah make us live to witness all those times, to have the time to complete everything that we are doing. Amen. I hope you have a very good Arabic time. Till we meet again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.